One of the dreams that the human being has always wanted to fulfill is to find a way to travel through time, in order to discover all the enigmas of history and, of course, correct wrong decisions and behaviors, to modify destiny. All this has been part of science fiction, but today, what was fantasy has a good chance of becoming reality. There is much speculation about what may be happening in particle accelerators in the world, such as CERN, where astrophysicists and quantum physicists have gained access to incredible knowledge, such as how to send messages to the past. A passionate search. Although not exactly in the accelerator of Hadrons was where the formula of transmitting information to the past was obtained, but thanks to the arduous research of Ronald Mallet, a young man who since he was 11 years old set himself the goal of becoming a scientist to look for how to travel to the past, motivated by the death of his father and thus save him. Mallet's father died of a heart attack at the age of 33 and could not overcome it. On the contrary, he was desperately looking for a way to go back and change everything, especially when he read a book that came into his hands, entitled The Time Machine. The first step he took in his ambitious goal was to study everything related to physics in a disciplined way. I had in my head the fixed idea that there should be a method to open dimensional portals or wormholes that communicated directly to a specific time and place. Ron was not an ordinary kid, but he used all his free time to imagine theories to make that chronological leap, and of course, he was the laughingstock of the entire university. The theory of relativity inspired dimensional travel. Nobody gave the slightest collaboration to that eccentric boy with his crazy ideas, but that motivated him even more to overcome the impossible. He obtained his degree of physics in 73 and was immediately employed in a factory. Shortly after, he was hired as a professor at the University of Connecticut. This allowed him to increase his knowledge and discover that Albert Einstein had found the fourth dimension of the universe, and this is neither more nor less than time. Then, in that dimension superior to this one of dense matter, which is space, is time, complementing the space-time equation. Consequently, it has been studied that the wormholes of the black holes curve space and time, and there was the key that Professor Mallet was looking for so much. At every moment our life is being affected by time and space, which in turn depend directly on speed and the law of gravity. We can see it in the satellites outside the atmosphere, that having less gravitational pressure, the time is recorded with some variations, and therefore, their clocks must be modified frequently. In the experiments of acceleration of particles, it has been possible to demonstrate that these, when traveling at the speed of light, their time of vitality multiplied by 30, they practically do not age, but travel through time. Mallet, noticing all these details, tried to work with lasers and apply them, nothing more nor less than the theory of the relativity of Einstein. He designed in his imagination a powerful laser machine that can bend time and space, one could say literally, the time machine. One of his biggest assumptions was that in order to send a person to another dimension, he would need to accumulate a huge amount of energy, so he considered that what he was able to do was send only messages to the past and mathematically demonstrate this great possibility. The only problem is that to create such a machine also requires a large capital, which is not officially known if it was achieved or if, in fact, this kind of technology is already developed but in a veiled manner. Quantum physicists affirm that at the moment in which an apparatus of these characteristics is created, the most certain thing is that from the future will come messages to the whole human race in the form of binary codes, warning of catastrophes, wars, bad governmental decisions, etc., in case of being well used. There are those who say that the Vatican and the main world powers, since the Second World War, keep this type of machines and artifacts in their possession, but obviously, they keep it in absolute silence. True or not, we live in a time of great technological and scientific advances. Many stories have arisen with respect to time travel, which previously sounded like fiction, and today, a quite possible quantum reality, and today, a quite possible